I'm Captain Pat with the Kayak Fishing Classics. I wanted to talk to you a little bit today about the stealth that we all enjoy in kayak fishing. The whole idea of kayaks beyond the obvious economy is the stealthiness, which I think is more important, which we get to where we're going to fish. When you think about it, and it kind of brings back to mind when I used to guide out of a flats boat, I'd go in off of a small creek with the flow of the tide into a small bay, and I could see the fish, and as I got into the bay, they would sense the displacement of the boat in the water, and they'd get all jittery and spooky. And I always thought that was kind of odd, but they can detect that, particularly snook. In a kayak, we have the advantage that the displacement is as such that we don't have that effect. In fact, many of us have just drifted right over fish. You know, whoa, you know, and didn't happen to see it, and there it is. So that's really important, but also equally important is the quietness in which we do everything. That's a big part of our stealth. So not being seen and also not being hurt. You know, when you're in your kayak and you clunk a paddle, or if you drop something into the sole of the deck and it clunks, that really amplifies through the kayak. When I was over on Mosquito Lagoon last year, we were fishing in the haul over on nighttime, standing ashore, we couldn't hear any fish, but when we got out on the water, we could hear the drum so loud echoing up through the kayaks. So it does act as a big amplifier, so to speak. So any little noise that you make in a kayak is your enemy, and it just blows the whole concept of being stealthy. So SeaDek is one of our sponsors, and we're very proud to have them. And I had them make a kit for our Predator 13 by Old Town, who is also a sponsor. And this kit's pretty cool. And when you talk to them, they'll make this. I'm going to show you how to install this. It's pretty simple. I scrubbed up the Predator real clean yesterday. And in a moment, when we reset the studio, I'm going to use some isopropyl alcohol. This is 70% alcohol. And I'll clean the surface in which it sticks to, and then just peel the back off and put these in the proper places. So I'm going to reset and show you how to do that, and I'll be right back. Thanks. Oh, hi. I just finished cleaning all this off with the isopropyl. It's surprising what it'll get off, so I wiped it down good all over. I popped the lid off of the center so that I can put this in without interfering with the lip of the Mod Pod cover. Okay, and then I'm going to peel these just from one end and then start it, get it in place, and peel it and set it, peel it and set it. And then I'm going to go over it lightly with this roller. Then when I get everything all done, I'm going to remove it from the studio and set it outside in the sun where it's really hot and let it bake it good and warm up good. And then I'm going to roll it down again. And being in a little bit cooler environment than outside in the sun should allow me a little bit of margin for air. I really don't know how sticky the SeaDek is yet, you know, with the backing removed, so we'll find out here. So I'm going to get to work here and show you how easy this really is. Okay, I'm going to start to peel on this and get this set. We've set the camera, so you probably can't see me too well, but you should be able to see where we're working. As you can see, this paper backing comes right off, so I'm going to peel it back a little bit to get my set. And before you do that, get in your mind's eye exactly where your starting point is. So if you want this nub in particular right against that corner or not, that's for you to determine. I'm letting the scupper hole be my guide. And the very end down here. And that's pretty good. I could shift it a tad, but then I'll lose this tab having any area to adhese to. That's kind of your call. About like that. Okay. Now I'm just going to lightly stick it and recheck my fit. I'm going to angle it just a little bit. Just depress it. Now I can lift it up and start working it down, much like, I'm just going to go ahead and take a big chunk of it out of there. It's much like how you do your the kayak fishing classics measuring tape, and just kind of roll it down, and it allows you to angle it. You can pull it up a little bit if you get a little off guide. There we go. A little more. That's really, really easy to work with. Now inspect your fit. Make sure it's where you want it before you get to pressing it down pretty good. Now I'm going to lightly roll it. This is really handy. We use this in the studio for matting photos. You really get into corners with it. Pretty simple. It's stuck down real good, so I'm going to leave that alone and I'm going to move on to the next piece. And you'll see it when I get it all done. Well, there you have it. It's all done. The SeaDek kit is installed. You saw how easy it is. I mean, it couldn't have been any easier at all. I've never done it before. It's really self-explanatory. That roller, it's a hard rubber, really did the trick. It's all set right now. So I'm ready to do some fishing. So put the Kayak back in your kayak. I know a lot of us stand up and fish. And the Old Town Predator is designed as a stand-up kayak. And when you're moving around, just the slightest little tap will make a lot of noise in the water. So get a SeaDek kit in your kayak. Become super stealthy. Thank you.